How's it going, everyone? This is GWR Studios, and today we are going to be finding some more goofs in Thomas and Friends. Today's episode is Thomas and Bertie. I hope you enjoy it. Alright, so at the beginning of the episode, Thomas is waiting at a junction when a bus pulls up beside him.
Hello, said Thomas. Who are you?
The bus tells him that his name is Bertie.
I'm Bertie.
And here comes the first goof. If we look at Thomas's boiler, we can see that there's a chip in it. Thomas then introduces himself to Bertie. Bertie remembers Thomas from the time that he took his passengers home after Thomas crashed into a snowdrift.
Ah, I remember now. You got stuck in the snow.
Bertie then tells Thomas that he's here to help his passengers, but this makes Thomas cross.
I can go faster than you.
Bertie says that he's faster, but Thomas says that he's faster. So in order to settle the argument, they agree to have a race. And here comes the next goof. If we look at the bottom left corner of the screen, we can see a camera shadow. The station master started the race.
Are you ready? Go!
Thomas had trouble getting up to speed, and Bertie took the lead. This made Annie and Clarabelle nervous.
Why don't you go fast? Why don't you go fast?
But Thomas wasn't worried because he remembered there was a level crossing up ahead. When Bertie makes it to the crossing, the narrator says that he's fuming.
There was Bertie fuming at the gates.
But Bertie appears to be happy. There's a big smile on his face. Thomas then puffs through the crossing, taking the lead.
Goodbye, Bertie.
Now Bertie's behind in the race and he has to catch up to Thomas. Now as the race continues, the narrator says that the road left the railway. Take a listen.
After that, the road left the railway so they couldn't see Bertie.
But this isn't true. There's a road right beside the tracks. And you're not gonna believe this next goof, Bertie the bus has no driver. As Bertie tried to catch up, Thomas had to stop at a station to drop off some passengers. He was very impatient, but as soon as the passengers got off, Thomas steamed away as fast as he could. But there's something in this scene that's not quite right. Did you notice the plane in the background? We can see that it's moving, but if we look closer, we can see that it has a clear disc for its propellers. And things just get more strange in the next scene. Thomas is now on Toby's branch line. We know this because he's passing Arlesburg Station, which is on Toby's branch line. And in the next scene, Annie and Clarabelle are gone. Just when Thomas thought he was ahead, Bertie the bus took the lead.
Oh dearie me, oh dearie me.
Thomas's driver encouraged him to keep going, and so did Annie and Clarabelle.
We'll beat Bertie yet, we'll beat Bertie yet.
But Thomas had to stop at a station to drop off some more passengers. But look at his face. He's wearing Percy's tired face. As Thomas stops to drop off some more passengers, Bertie the bus is already leaving.
Goodbye.
This makes Thomas sad.
We've lost.
But he felt a little better after getting a drink. As soon as the signal switched, Thomas went off to catch Bertie.
Hurrah, we're off! Hurrah, we're off!
As Thomas crosses the bridge, he hears a honking sound. Bertie got stopped by a traffic light. And now Thomas is back in the lead. As soon as the light turned green, Bertie took off. Thomas was going as fast as he could, and Bertie was having a hard time keeping up. There's some more studio equipment. Thomas flew through the tunnel as fast as he could, leaving Bertie far behind. And in this next scene, we can see a camera holder in front of Thomas.
We've done it! We've done it!
Thomas puffed as fast as he could until he made it to the station. And right behind him was Bertie the bus. Thomas had won the race. All of the passengers were cheering for him. But they also cheered for Bertie.
Well done, Thomas, said Bertie.
Bertie congratulates Thomas, and he tells him that in order to beat him over a hill, he'd have to grow wings and be an airplane. But there's a goof in this scene. In the previous scene, there were a lot of people standing around Bertie. But in the very next scene, a lot of the people are gone. And there's one more goof that I noticed. In the top left corner, there's some more studio equipment. Thomas and Bertie are now good friends, but Bertie's passengers don't like to be bounced around like peas in a frying pan, and Sir Topham Hatt warns Thomas not to race anymore. But secretly, Thomas and Bertie want to race again someday.
I don't think they ever will. Do you?
And this marks the end of the episode. Okay guys, so those were all the goofs that I found in Thomas and Bertie. This has to be one of my favorite episodes. Now remember, if you saw a goof that I didn't point out, please leave a comment below and let me know. Thanks for watching and have a great day. We are the champions.